Good morning. My name is Silvia Botero. I'm the VP Exploration for Endeavour Mining in Côte d'Ivoire. I'm working here since 2013, and today we are here to speak about the Fetekro project. This project is located in West Africa, more precisely in the north central part of Côte d'Ivoire, and we are approximately 500 kilometers north of the economical capital, Abidjan. We are in the southern part of the West African Craton, and where the Sassandra Fault limits the western side of the Archean domain to the eastern side of the Paleoproterozoic domain. This domain is characterized by narrow volcanic belts and large structured sedimentary basin that are bound and intruded by granitoids complex. Most of the major ore body are classified as orogenic gold deposit. And indeed, the main gold field that have been explored in West Africa lie within these Proterozoic rocks, and the West African Craton hosts several multi-million ounces deposits. It's one of the most world prospective geological setting for gold exploration, and the resources exceed the 10,000 tons of gold. So indeed, it's the right place where to be. The Fetekro permit, hosting Lafigué deposit, sits in the northern part of the Toumoudi Fetekro greenstone belt, which, along with the Bonikro, Iré, and Agbaou gold mines, is one of the most known productive Birimian belts in Côte d'Ivoire. When we are in the permit, the dominant lithology that have been mapped consists of mafic rocks, namely metabasalts and meta-andesites that have been intruded by metagabbro and then granodiorite. We have some felsic metavolcanics, and in the central parts of the permit, there are metasediments that have been folded in the eastern and in northwestern corner of the permit. We have some granitic complex. All these Birimian complex was affected by a transpassive deformation, and this event is led to the development of a sinistral north-northwest-south-southwest shore zone that comprises a relay zone that are marked by east-northeast thrusts that are gently dipping south-southeast and are intruded by granodioritic bodies. The mineralization is mainly controlled by this brittle ductile thrust fault, and up to now has been recognized over 2 kilometers long, an east-northeast axis, and the down-deep extension has been demonstrated over 1 kilometer so far. The gold mineralization is hosted in a calcite quartz tourmaline sulfide veins that are associated with a chlorite biotite proximal alteration, including numerous crusts of very fine grains of tourmaline. The gold mineralization is specially associated with granodiorite, metagabbro and mafic metavolcanic rocks. The lodes generally occur on lithological or structural discontinuities and typically are the granodiorite edge. At deposit scale, the lodes pinch and swell, and this is what it makes this deposit difficult to explore. and the thickness can be up to 40 meters. The new geological model and structural model that consist in multiple stacked loads sub-parallel to the main gold-bearing structures was first confirmed by scout drilling in underexplored areas and then followed by infill drilling. What has been achieved in this project? In this project, we can say that in the last 3 years, we did more than 1,050,000 meters of drilling that were associated to metallurgical tests, and they allowed to increase the resources from nearly 400,000 ounces to 2.5 million ounces, all that in only 3 years. This was possible thanks to an efficient exploration methodology and an optimization of the whole process exploration process. So we, in this way, we advanced very quickly from an exploration process to a preliminary economic assessment. If I have to say which innovative methodology allow us to get to this point, well, to be honest, I think that there is not one methodology, but we combine several approach. The first one, it was the Fetecro success is consistent with the Endeavour strategy. When in 2016 Endeavour set up the new strategy for a 5 years at times, exploration was recognized as a pillar. And indeed, there was a will to create internal growth and a lower cost from a greenfield assets rather than buying an advanced project. So what we applied was an aggressive exploration strategy combined to a step-by-step exploration approach, but in a faster way. How it was possible? Well, let's say that we work in several spheres, in several domains at the same time. First of all, we create a company culture. So a lot of people have been hired in 2016-17. We create a relationship with the local university, but also with foreign universities. We ask for expertise to international consultants. And on the same time, we create really a team spirit and we work to empower our employees in order that each of them take responsibility of what he was doing. I've worked in several projects in several countries, and a lot of time I saw that when there is the top management that is based let's say 5,000 kilometers away from the field, and he wants to take the control of what is happening, is not working. You cannot have 7 rigs, 10 rigs working, and have a boss that is sit in a Toronto office, in a Perth office, telling you where you have to drill and what you have to do. So our work, firstly, was to train our geologists to be committed to results, not to be sit close to a rig, but to understand what was happening to a rig. Speaking by geologists, what we are doing now, every one of our geologists is sit on a rig with his cross section in front of him, in front of her, and he has the responsibility to collect data and to interpret what is happening. When you come back to the office and you say the planet holds is too short, is too late. You do not have the time again to come back to the field and ask to the rigger to go forward. So what allows us to have these so good results, quality results in a short times, was this commitment of people to what they were doing. It happened that every day I was asking for the quick log coming from the field, and I was telling to the chief geologist, look, this hole is short, you should go in, going longer. He replied to me, it's done. Another time I said, look, it looks like the mineralization is going down deep. We should add at least an hole down deep. Reply to me, it's done. So you do that one time, two times, five times, and you realize that people know what they are doing. They understand perfectly what they are doing. This is possible only when the strategy is well-defined in the top, and when it's coming down and the goal and the objectives are well settled and each of us is taking ownership and responsibility of it. So I think that this process optimization was possible thanks to the implication of the internal stakeholders and the external stakeholders. We work with in an interactive process with the geologists, the resource department. Before to have all the results, we were speaking and sit with the resources. They give us guidance, what we can do. We had a good assessment of our results. We were able to communicate to the hierarchy. They was able to have a fast decision flow in coming back to us with unlocked budget, and we were able to work. At the same time, we have the support function that were there. We have to understand that we are working in central of Côte d'Ivoire. Sure, they are infrastructures, but the local suppliers are not the same that you can have in Canada, or you can have in South Africa, or you can have in Australia. So you need to anticipate needs. We need to be proactive. So when it's taken 3 months to get suppliers here, if we have to drill holes at 25 meters apart and we have to control the downhole deviation, it means that the drillers have to anticipate the equipment to be shipped to Côte d'Ivoire. And this is what we have. What we did. We anticipate each phase of the project, collaborating with the support function, the logistic, the financial, the legal, the CSR, and with all the external stakeholders that are drillers, laboratories, universities, consultants, local community, authorities, and so on. So it was like a puzzle, and each piece of this puzzle was coming in the good place and the good moment. So if I have to say why this project was successful, well, I think that, we are in the part of the world where the exploration that is still very underexplored for several reasons. Côte d'Ivoire is delayed compared to Burkina or compared to Mali because there was security instability, and also because there was not a government intention to develop the mining sector. Since 2012, things have changed here. The government laws encourage company to come and to work and to explore Côte d'Ivoire. We have these Birimian terrain that are so big here. They represent more than 75% of the Côte d'Ivoire ground. And we see that there is still room to find multi-million ounces deposit. So we were in the good place. Second, we put in place the good team with the good governance and with a clear company strategy that was declined in well-identified objective for the project. And finally, and above all, we have the commitment of everyone to deliver good results. We are a stage now in Fetecro that the project is going forward. The pre-feasibility study is ongoing. The mining authorization are in demand or in progress. But well, La Figue deposit with these 2.5 million is just maybe, let's say, a small window of 10 square kilometers in a permit of 250 square kilometers. There are other targets there. We know that the La Figue deposit is still open at depth and along strike. Our teams are busy now to do the extension drilling, and we are very excited to get the results back, to see what we can add in La Figue, but also to start the new adventure in the nearby targets. And endeavor is not only resuming its exploration in Fetecro, as I said, is a willingness of the company to continue with this internal growth. We have several permits in Côte d'Ivoire. Some of them get some good results, and we are busy to renovate our pipeline of projects and to point out the next Fetecro, let's say. Thank you very much for your time and the interest shown in Fetecro project. The PFS results will be released in Q1, and we are excited to share them with you. We will continue to work on Fetecro permit in order to develop other targets than La Figue, and hopefully they will be the object of our next discovery. Thanks, everybody.